What's up, subscribers? Welcome back to the channel. In this video, we're going to be talking about some updates for Sundial Growers stock, ticker SNDL. In this video, we'll be taking a look at some recent news regarding SNDL, including talks about a potential merger with Canopy Growth, as well as taking a look at the recent stock chart. But first, if you'd like to get updates about our new videos discussing the stock market and personal finances, as well as being entered into our 1,000 subscriber giveaway, be sure to hit that subscribe button if you haven't already. And while you're down there, be sure to check out the links in the description to get your free shares of stock from Robinhood and Webull if you haven't already. So with all of that being said, grab a cup of coffee or your favorite beverage of choice, and let's jump into it. For those of you who may be coming across this channel for the first time, Sundial Growers is a company that we talk about fairly often here. Sundial Growers, trading on the New York Stock Exchange under the ticker SNDL, is a small-cap Canadian Michael Jackson company. Recently, there has been a ton of hype in the Michael Jackson industry because of multiple different political news stories, such as the election of Joe Biden and the passing of the MORE Act in the House of Representatives, that has led to a ton of volatility and excitement around SNDL stock. This excitement continued last week when news broke that Sundial Growers and larger competitor Canopy Growth are talking about a potential merger. Canopy is another Canadian-based Michael Jackson company which trades on the New York Stock Exchange under the ticker CGC. In addition to the news of this potential merger with Canopy, SNDL just recently announced that they are now debt-free, which has led to even more excitement and caused the stock price to soar this past week. Coming off of the news of this improvement in their balance sheet, shares of SNDL stock skyrocketed, up almost 30% in intraday trading on news of SNDL becoming debt-free. This news comes at a great time for Sundial Growers, who, like many other Michael Jackson companies, were struggling financially, announcing that just 2 quarters after its IPO, it was already running out of cash, but as of now, it has paid down $227 million worth of debt this year alone. Sundial Growers were able to accomplish this by financial restructuring, through selling of assets and raising capital in order to become completely debt-free. Now, without any debt, Sundial Growers is in an excellent place financially, with nearly $62 million worth of cash on hand on its balance sheet. Getting back to the potential merger talks with Canopy Growth, while nothing is official yet, this news has definitely gotten me excited as an investor. And we've seen multiple other mergers in the Michael Jackson industry this year, with Tilray and Aphria being one of the most notable. But despite all of the positive news surrounding Sundial Growers recently, there definitely continue to be multiple bears. Despite of improving sales of Michael Jackson this year, this author believes that Sundial Growers continues to face numerous challenges, noting that one of the largest challenges ahead of it is the possibility of a reverse stock split. By that, the author is referring to something that we've talked about previously here on the channel, with the NASDAQ granting Sundial Growers an additional 180-day compliance period in order to meet the expectation that the share has to be trading at greater than $1 in order to remain listed on the New York Stock Exchange. This raises the possibility that if Sundial Growers' share price is not greater than $1 per share by that time, then Sundial Growers may have to resort to doing a reverse stock split in order to meet those expectations. The author goes on to state that they believe that it's imperative that in the upcoming quarter, Sundial needs to improve its sales, stating that higher revenue numbers will also allow the company to pay down its debt and raise its share price. But until there is progress on this front, Sundial Growers stock comes with an element of risk and that they recommend keeping your eye on this stock but hold off on investing right now. But like we just mentioned, Sundial has already accomplished one of those tasks whenever they just recently announced that they're now debt-free. With all of that being said, now let's jump over and take a look at the SNDL chart. As of recording this video, the market is currently closed and Sundial Growers was last trading at around 47 cents per share. Over the past trading week, Sundial did start the week out with a strong uptrend, trading at around 57 cents per share before slowly pulling back for the rest of the week. As we prepare to enter into the shortened trading week because of the New Year's holiday, I believe that we will continue to see SNDL share price bounce around this same range, with an area of support coming in at around 45 cents per share and an area of resistance at around 60 cents per share. As we put the holiday season behind us and prepare to enter into the new year, I believe that the Michael Jackson industry is going to be looking for the next catalyst to help propel share prices higher. I believe that this catalyst will come from the Georgia runoff elections, which will officially take place on January 5th. If the Democrats are able to win both of these elections and take control of the Senate, then this could be a game changer for the Michael Jackson industry as a whole, not only benefiting SNDL, but the entire industry. As of recording this video, it's estimated that nearly 2.1 million early votes have already been casted in the Georgia runoff elections. And if the presidential election can provide any insight to those votes, then it's highly likely that the majority will be for the Democratic candidates. I'll definitely be watching for the results of the Georgia runoff elections closely, but honestly, regardless of what happens, I still believe that Sundow has a ton of potential ahead of it. While it definitely is a risky investment considering how small of a market cap SNDL has and how much competition it already has in the industry, it's definitely a company that I'm willing to take some risk on through a small position. What are your thoughts on SNDL stock? Is this a company that you're invested in, or do you think that it's too risky and you'd rather put your money in a different company? Be sure to comment down below and let me know what you think. And while you're down there, be sure to comment and let me know if there are any other companies or topics that you would like me to talk about in future videos.
As a reminder, this video is for entertainment purposes only. I am not a certified financial planner. I'm a resident physician with an interest in personal finances and investing. Please make sure you're doing your own research before you make any financial decisions. If you haven't already, be sure to check out this video about how to participate in our 1,000 subscriber giveaway. And please be sure to smash that like button and click on the subscribe button for the YouTube algorithm and to help support my channel. Thanks, everyone. Have a great day.